When working with rational exponents, it's important to remember rules of fractions. When we want to multiply to get to 1 when talking about fractions, remember that if you have a over b, you can simply multiply by the reciprocal b over a to get 1. We clear a rational exponent by using a reciprocal exponent. Remember also that if you have a to the m over n, you can rewrite that as n as the root and m, the numerator of your fractional exponent, as the exponent. You can also rewrite this as the nth root of a all raised to the m, because you simplify this and then you raise it to the exponent. We're going to stick with this method right here as we go on. Here's how we can check. If you want to check to see if the rational exponent has even roots, you look in the denominator. And if you want to see if there are two solutions, the original rational exponent has even exponents. And that is in the numerator. Let's try some examples. In example 1, we have 3x minus 6 raised to the 3 halves. The way to clear that would be to multiply by the reciprocal 2 thirds. And thus, you'd get an exponent of 1. Since anything raised to the first power is itself, we don't even have to worry about it anymore. But whatever we do to one side, we have to also do to the other side. So now we have 64 third root, and it's all raised to the second power. Now, we can simplify further. The cubed root of 64 is 4. Raised to the second power gives us 16. Now we can solve for x. By adding 6 to both sides, we get 3x is equal to 22. Now if we divide both sides by 3, we get x is equal to 22 thirds. We can check to see if this solution is correct by substituting 2 thirds in for x. When we do that, we get 22 minus 6 raised to the 3 halves, and we're checking to see if it's equal to 64. Raised to the 3 halves. if we take the square root of 16 and then we cube it, is that equal to 64? 4 cubed is 64. So this answer is correct. Now if we look at example 2, we can multiply both sides by the reciprocal of the exponent, 5/4. And this gives us 5x plus 1 is equal to 16 raised to the 5/4. The numerator is the exponent, and the denominator is now the index. So it will be the 4th root of 16 raised to the 5th power. Recall that 16 is 2 to the 4th, and so we can rewrite this as 2. And that's all raised to the 5th power because of the exponent outside. So we have 5x plus 1 is equal to 32. And remember, since we took an even root, we have to give this a plus or minus sign. So now, subtract 1 from both sides. And divide by 5 on both sides. So I have x is equal to negative 1 plus or minus 32 over 5. Since there are no radicals in my numerator, I will find the two exact values for x when the value for 32 is positive, I get negative 1 plus 32 over 5, and when 32 is negative, I get negative 1 minus 32 over 5. So x is equal to 31/5, or 33, negative 33/5.